Hi everyone, I'm Dr. White. I am a board-certified pulmonologist, critical care, and sleep medicine specialist with Integra Health in Temecula, California. Today I would like to discuss with you a topic that is one of my passions, lung cancer. The CDC identified lung cancer as the second most common cancer in the United States. But did you know that it is the most lethal type of cancer, being the leading cause of cancer deaths worldwide in both men and women? There are two main types, small cell lung cancer and non-small cell lung cancer. These two types grow differently and are treated differently. So let us begin by discussing some of the causes of lung cancer. Number one is smoking. It is the leading risk factor for lung cancer, and that includes cigarettes, cigars, and pipes. Some of the other causes of lung cancer are secondhand smoke, exposure to radon, exposure to asbestos, which can also increase the risk for mesothelioma, family history of lung cancer, and previous radiation therapy to the lungs. Unfortunately, most lung cancers do not cause any symptoms until they have spread. And that is because there are very little pain receptors inside the lungs, so even a big tumor growing won't cause much pain. There are a small percentage of people with early lung cancer who do have symptoms. So let's discuss some of those possible common symptoms. A cough that does not go away or gets worse. Coughing up blood or rust-colored sputum. Chest pain that is often worse with deep breathing, coughing, or laughing. Hoarseness of the voice. A loss of appetite. Unexplained weight loss. Shortness of breath. Feeling tired or weak. A new onset of wheezing. Or even infections such as bronchitis and pneumonia that don't go away or keep coming back. Screening for individuals at high risk has the potential to dramatically improve lung cancer survival rates by finding the disease at an earlier stage when it is more likely to be curable. Early detection by low-dose CT screening can decrease lung cancer mortality by 14 to 20% among high-risk populations. Per the American Cancer Society's guideline, yearly lung cancer screening with low-dose CT scans are recommended for people between age 55 to 74 who are current smokers or smokers who have quit in the past 15 years and have at least a 30-pack year smoking history. Low-dose CT can pick up nodules in the lungs as small as a couple millimeter. So if a nodule or multiple nodules are found, seek expert evaluation by a lung specialist. Depending on the size, shape, and amount of the nodules, we may recommend close surveillance or a biopsy, which can be attained by one of two ways. If the nodule is located in the periphery of the lung, a percutaneous needle biopsy is usually recommended. This is where a needle is punctured from outside of the body through the skin and soft tissue structure into the lungs and into the core of the nodule to get a small piece of tissue sample. Traditionally, this is done under fluoroscopy to guide the physician to the correct location. However, a novel technology now allows this procedure to be done using an electromagnetic navigational guided method that uses a percutaneous electromagnetic tip-tracked needle to obtain core biopsy specimens, eliminating the radiation exposure to both the patient and the medical staff with the traditional fluoroscopy technique. If the nodule is located more centrally, a bronchoscopy is the preferred method to reach the nodule for a biopsy. A bronchoscope is an instrument that is inserted into the airways, usually through the nose or the mouth, to allow the pulmonologist to examine the patient's airways for abnormalities such as foreign bodies, bleeding, tumor, or inflammation. Specimens may be taken from inside the lungs. However, smaller nodules that are not located inside the airway may be difficult to biopsy, as those cannot be visualized, making the yield less accurate. A newer technology called navigational bronchoscopy has tremendously helped to improve the accuracy of the biopsy. A navigational bronchoscopy uses a special bronchoscope to examine and treat lesions in areas of the lungs that are inaccessible using a regular bronchoscopy. navigational bronchoscopy combines electromagnetic navigation with real-time CT images to create a three-dimensional map of the lungs. Pulmonologists are then able to use this map to guide the navigational bronchoscope, which includes an extended working channel and guide wire, to difficult-to-access areas of the lungs to take a biopsy, or even help guide radiation therapy directly to a hard-to-reach lesion. Lastly, if your CT scan shows enlarged lymph nodes in the mediastinum or the hilum, which are the areas between your two lungs, these can be biopsied safely using a technique called EBUS. Endobronchial ultrasound is a procedure that uses ultrasound technology in combination with bronchoscopy to visualize the walls of airways and surrounding structure to accurately take a biopsy of the lymph nodes that lie outside the airways. All three of these novel technologies, the EBUS, the navigation bronchoscopy, and the electromagnetic guided transthoracic needle aspiration, are now all available locally in Temecula and are performed by our doctors here at Integra Health. So remember, early detection is key to survival. A diagnosis of lung cancer no longer has to be a death sentence if caught early and may even allow the chance for a complete cure. So if you or your loved ones are at risk for lung cancer, contact us for further evaluation. Please visit our website, integrahealthpc.com, for more information on lung cancer and the technologies we offer.